endocrine system and chemical coordination. So here the endocrine system, in that hormones are the basic concepts of the endocrine system. Okay, hormones are the basic concepts of the endocrine system. So here the hormones are referred as the biochemical integrators. Okay, so why we call the biochemical integrators of hormones? So by this way, the hormones are released into the blood, then that hormones are transported to the different tissues or organs, then the organs will work more effectively. That's why the hormones are biochemical integrators. Right, here the endocrine secretions are released into the circulating body fluids. Okay, so then these circulatory body fluids are transferred into the different organs or tissues. Organs and tissues. Right, so suppose these chemical or hormones are played a major role to maintaining the homeostasis. So in higher animals, these hormones are functioned as the regulator molecules. Okay, alright. So suppose some of the hormones such as oxytocin and vasopressin. These are the hormones are derived from or secreted from the CNS. Okay, so central nervous system. Then these hormones are transported or transmitted through the circulatory systems. Okay, right. So hormones, generally they are called as biochemical integrators. So generally in that hormones are developed from the endocrine systems. So they are reached into the certain organs or tissues. So here the hormones will help to maintaining the homeostasis. Okay, right. Next, right. Most of the animals. Right. So here the hormones are called as biochemical integrators. So why it is called the biochemical integrators means, so suppose the hormones are released into the blood, then it transferred to the blood to the different organs or tissues. So then the organ of the body will works effectively. So that's why it is called as biochemical integrators. And next, generally the endocrine system, the endocrine secretions are released into the body. So, and that is transferred through the circulatory body fluids. So they are circulated into the particular organs or tissues through the circulatory body fluids. So in that, the endocrine system, the hormones are played a major role to maintaining the homeostasis, right? And in higher animals, the hormones are functioned as the regulatory or controllery molecules. So some of the hormones like here oxytocin and vasopressin, they are secreted from the central nervous system. So that means here CNS, central nervous system, and they are transported into the different organs through the circulatory systems or circulatory fluids. Okay, right. Generally, most of the animals they released the regulatory molecules called as pheromones. So into the pheromones are released into the exterior part of the body. Exterior parts of the body. So once see here, the pheromones are helps to participate in the chemo communication. So here, what is the meaning of chemo communication? Means, suppose let's see here, a group of animals of ants living in a particular area. Suppose in that they are going to search for food in different ways. So in that situation, the one of the ant that can be find a food material. So in such area, so then that information will pass to their group of members. So then they start releasing the chemical substances like pheromones from that food material to the living area. So after the group of ants can going along this way and to find one of the food material, and they collect each and other.